get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Thank you.
get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Thank you. That's a good looking truck you got there.
I got a beck of a deal.
Yeah, when I bought my truck there, they made it so easy. I said, Beck, yeah.
Beck, yeah.
Beck, yeah.
Are they saying heck or Beck?
Beck, it's the only name in trucks around here.
Come on down, see us today. We've got what you need at Beck Chevrolet.
Hear nature calling. Feel a cool splash. Smell fresh air. See the sights. Taste a sunset. Get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Thank you.
essence of Old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Thank you. events in our lives that define us, though at the time they didn't seem that way. Buying our first home, watching my little angel sleep, feeling so proud. It's those moments that I've treasured the most. I've never taken a second of it for granted, because I knew one day I would share it with you. Capital City Bank. More than your bank, your banker.
Thank you.
Get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
We stand for the hard workers, the driven, and the inspired. For those who don't wait for opportunity to knock, but walk right up and shake his hand. We admire the early starters, the late bloomers, the roll-your-sleeves-up leaders who don't just build companies, but build communities. We salute those who relentlessly pursue their dreams. For in your courage, we all rise. Capital City Bank. More than your bank, your banker.
Thank you.
Get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Begin here, go anywhere. SJR State is your gateway to Florida's university system, as well as your local source for more than 40-plus career tracks. St. John's River State College, now offering bachelor's degrees.
Your life.
Your course.
Your future.
Hear nature calling. Feel a cool splash. Smell fresh air. See the sights. Taste a sunset. Get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Thank you.
Get a sense of old Florida and explore Putnam County.
Begin here, go anywhere. SJR State is your gateway to Florida's university system, as well as your local source for more than 40-plus career tracks. St. John's River State College, now offering bachelor's degrees.
Your life.
Your course.
Your future.
Oh, yeah.
So first of all, I want to thank everyone for coming to our match today. This next 15, 20 minutes is about a year and a half in the making, not about an hour and a half. So I want everyone to understand. I usually do like one by one, but I always feel like I'm shortchanging someone or over. So I really want to address kind of two groups here. So first I want to talk about this young lady here to present. Lucy is my fifth transfer from the university in 10 years of coaching at the junior college level. And my previous four have been complete and utter busts. And so when Lucy reached out to me, I really tried to do my due diligence. And in the small world that volleyball is, where she's from, my buddy just happened to be the head coach, I just got hired, he's coaching at the club she played at. So I really did my homework on her as a human being. That's really going to be the theme tonight, what we're talking about, the kind of people we have. So I am so grateful that Lucy chose to come here for this second year. Such a constant influence on this team. She's one of the goofiest players we have here. And I think at times like these, that's really important that we don't lose sight of what really matters. She's done a tremendous job for us this year. She was a conference player of the week last week for offense, which is a pretty cool honor. And she has given me a new hope in looking at transfers. This was like my last ditch effort to accept the transfer. It was just becoming a nightmare. So she has given me hope that girls can go somewhere and come somewhere else and be better for it. So at least we have a little. Freshman year, and seeing how the program I felt was going in a positive direction when I left here, and then while I didn't know the personnel or anything, I just saw the record. I had some concerns, so I knew I had to go after character first. And Edith is one of the most pleasant human beings I've ever been fortunate enough to meet. She really brings that it thing. You know, we watch Sunday football and they talk about these quarterbacks that it, and we can't put it in words. But as far as a teammate and a human being, and everything is said about her was the words I wanted to hear about a human being. Again, that's really the thing. Good people. And so Arena came here, and it was that weird dynamic where she came with a club teammate. And, you know, you don't want to tell one you like them and the other you don't, but, you know, I was really hoping Arena would choose us. Cassidy's great, whatever. But, you know, I thought, I knew just the way Nick described her as a person, that, you know, her work ethic, her mind for the game, just how engaged she is. I knew she'd be a really, really good fit. So I got to discover where real estate is and go to Shogun. Is that a treat? And the town's got two restaurants, and one of them was Taco Bell. The other one better be good. So that was a lot of fun for me, and so I'm really grateful for you being here. Thank you so much. So once we got going in the club, I was actually coaching my son. And when we moved back here, I met a gentleman who's kind of big in the club world. And he's like, hey, I know this kid who's lucky. So I get this email that says something Spider-Man. Right?
Oh, it's like sell me on Spider-Man.
Sell me on Spider-Man or something like that. So I go to this recruiting combine thing at OVA, and there's like two other coaches and like 100-something kids, and I think like four students, like 8 or 9 years or something. And so we're talking, and they're like, oh, this is a bust. In my mind, I'm like, man, I'm here for this kid, and I just watch the whole time. And the combine was ran, in my opinion, so poorly. But what I noticed about this kid is like, when there was a ball way over there, she went and got it. When the rest of the gym was doing nose-goes and I don't care, she went and got the ball. When a coach needed to be fed, she was there to do that. And again, trying to build culture with good people, I didn't really watch her play volleyball. I didn't even know she didn't play libero on the team. I didn't know she was a DS. I just knew she was a good human being, and she was everything I wanted, and I could, you know, we could teach some friends. So we got her up here, and she's been such a good influence. She's 19, going on 30. So very mature, very organized. She's taught me how to be more organized. She made me realize girls need a schedule months in advance. I don't want the day up kind of guy. But it's been a needed piece of this team and this program's success. So, Selena, thank you so much for being here. To like March or April now, and I get an email from, I don't know if it's Jordan or Jamal, hopefully it's you, saying, hey, we were at a club tournament in Texas, and we played a Florida team, and we're still looking, and they said you were one of three schools that need a second. I'm like, wow, sometimes, you know, it just comes your way, geez. So, I set up a time to talk to her, and I'll never forget it. We talked for maybe 3.5-4 minutes. And I hand the phone, and my wife really goes, what do you think? I said, no way is she coming. She had no questions, she had nothing to say. It was like pulling teeth. And, you know, I need a center who's like, that's a disaster. There's no way. And maybe a day and a half later, she calls me back and says, I want to. And I'm just like, okay, I'm done predicting who's going to say yes and who's going to say no. So then she comes out to visit with her mom, and we want to take her out, and she tells me I eat hamburgers. Hamburgers. That's it. Nothing but hamburgers. So we take her to Sunset Grill, you know, trying to get the St. Augustine, and where's a hamburger? Nothing on it. Well, at least she's honest. So Jordan is going to leave here with the second most assists in the history of this program, as far as I can tell. If we can get it done early November and make a deep run come in as 17, 18-year-old girls, leaving as 20-year-old women who like have a clue on what their life might be. And Jordan has really transitioned. She has a voice at her top, and she's really grown into a leader. So Jordan, thank you. As a coach, because you know that they're figuring it out and they're going to be okay. So, Jordan, I'm so grateful you're here. Phoenix, and I'm on the phone for a good, I don't know, 90 minutes, 2 hours with this mall, which is Spirit Center Vision, down to Florida, New Jersey. And, I mean, right off, we're in New Mexico, phone's coming in and out, and she just keeps calling me back. And again, I've seen, honestly, about a 17-second clip. Okay, so I have no idea what I'm doing. But man, did I stumble onto something pretty cool. Kendall is probably one of the most physically gifted players I've had the opportunity to coach. As soon as we can get the head to agree with the body all the time, she's going to be special to watch. So, Kendall has done a lot of growing up here. She was a thorn in my side a lot last year. But she's, again, it's that whole growing up piece. It's such a fun thing to see. Kendall is on pace to have one of the most efficient offensive seasons we've had in my time here, let alone the history of the program. She's one of, I think, two or three girls to accumulate 110 blocks. So she's going to leave here with her name on some records. And we're excited to see where volleyball takes her. So they're going to leave here as the winningest class to come through. And then your task will be to one up. Again, when I decided to come back, and we had this decision about moving to Division II, the focus became character and quality. And this class, this group, has set the standard for the future of this program. We talk a lot about changing culture. It's really hard to change culture, but this level is even harder to maintain because no one's here for more than, in total, about 14 months. And between their 2 years of attending here, they're in the lack of living here for 14 to 16 months. And so these guys, hopefully, have set a foundation that you guys can build upon. And hopefully next year, you're at 40, whatever it is, or 50, or whatever we can get to. Okay? These guys are currently 7-2 in conference play. Okay? A half a game ahead of the team we just played. They're 6-2. We can take care of business Wednesday. We'll finish with 8 conference wins. That has never happened. If we can take care of business Wednesday, and they win their last two, we will finish as co-champions of the Sun Lakes League in conference. Volleyball winning in conference, if you take a look at there, and I joke about this all the time, when they were the MFC conference runner-up, they were one of three schools. So they got second out of three. So they beat one team. And so I don't consider what we've accomplished and that remotely in the same stretch. Okay, we've won 18 matches. I think we're going to break the 20 plateau plus up. So what they've done here is so important. My first go around here, we had the best GPA on campus the last 2 years. We did not. This last year, we did once again. We have a nice dinner at President Stein. Look forward to doing that again this spring. We once again have the best GPA. So this is just a class that I will never forget. We have pushed this program in a specific direction, so I'm grateful they're here. We have done way longer than I thought I would. But parents, thank you for your support. Thank you for trusting me to coach your daughter. Hopefully continuing another month and a half. And I'm just really, really grateful to Christians. Thank you so much, and thank you to you.
Thank you.
I don't doubt that. I don't doubt that.